The Philippines looking to generate around $100 billion in investments in the next 5 years as a result of the trilateral meeting in Washington. Manila's envoy to Washington, Jose Manuel Romualdez, says the Marcos administration has made an economic package covering the energy, semiconductor, cybersecurity sectors, among others. Meanwhile, Romualdez insists that the three allies are not looking to provoke any country.
We know clearly what we want to do, which is to protect our territory and our sovereign rights. And so all of these things that we're doing is precisely in that direction. You know, for so many years, the Filipino patience has been stretched to the limit. And we're now at the point where, are we just going to sit and see our fishermen suffer? We just want to be given our right to be able to explore our own environment, our territory, the respect for international law.
Meanwhile, U.S. National Security Communications Advisor John Kirby says there is no reason for China to, quote, overreact to the multilateral strategies happening in the region, specifically the recent quadrilateral exercises involving the Philippines, Australia, Japan, and the United States.
This is about freedom of navigation. It's about adherence to international law. It's about proving the simple point that we and our allies will fly, sail, and operate wherever international law permits us to do. And it does in the South China Sea, and we did.
Now, on the eve of the trilateral summit, two U.S. senators introduced a bipartisan bill to provide Manila with $2.5 billion to boost its defense against Chinese pressure. The bill was put forward by Republican Bill Hagerty and Democrat Tim Kaine. It authorizes $500 million a year in foreign military financing to the Philippines over 5 years or until 2029. It seeks to help modernize Manila's defense capabilities, including coastal, air and land defense, maritime security, intelligence, and defensive cybersecurity. Senators Hagerty and Kaine said it is critical to deepen cooperation with the Philippines and provide it with support in the face of China's growing aggression in the West Philippine Sea. U.S. President Joe Biden and Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida boosting their country's defense cooperation in a move that's seen to counter China and Russia. America and its allies have been bolstering their militaries amid growing threats from China and to deter any attempt to seize Taiwan, a self-ruled island that Beijing claims as its own. Biden said U.S. and Japan militaries will cooperate with a joint command structure. They will also develop a new air missile defense network together with Australia. During a lavish state dinner, Biden and Kishida said the alliance between their nations is stronger than ever.
We are the same, Japan and the United States. We may be divided by distance, but the generations after generation, we've been brought together with the same hopes, the same values, the same commitment to democracy and freedom, and to dignity for all. And today, without question, our alliance is literally stronger than it has ever been.
Japan and the United States are united than ever before. I believe that the Pacific Ocean has brought Japan and the United States together and so close because of the pioneering spirit of those who came before us and frontier spirit that we all have in common.